What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Welcome to The Word. As always, on the left side of your screen, that is Filthy Smalls.
What up, what up?
Fresh out the dentist. In the middle, that is Robbie D.
Allegedly.
And as always, I am your host, C-O-D-Y, sponsored by Soundcheck, soundcheckdenver.com, where Denver bands and musicians have practiced their passion since 2014. And if you're feeling what we bring to the table each and every week, We have options. We're all about options here. We like to, you know, keep things out in the open. We're non-committal. Even though these two guys are married, I holding it down on that end.
Ladies, look out,
so to speak.
We're not married to each other.
Yeah, they're just
the same.
No,
they're
homo.
Married to women, separate weddings, the whole bit. But we like to keep our options open. There is a subscription option. You can subscribe to the channel.
Facts.
There's a comments option. You can comment on these videos to help drive the engagement.
Or hate on my lisp.
Yeah, if you just want to throw some shade in the comments, that's an option too. Like I said, lots of options here. And the final option we're offering is the like button. That one's the simple one.
I'd say the subscribe button's more important.
It's pretty
you get
important.
Everything.
Do anything, please.
If you're afraid of commitment, though... wink, wink, nudge, nudge. You could just tap that like button. Just give it one little tap.
It's a little tappy tap.
So if you're Cody Russelling out there, you know, just hit that like button.
Yeah, yeah. Just get that one thing going. Just to drive the engagement, just that little bit. We appreciate it. Much appreciated.
Hell yeah.
Help us spread the word.
Facts.
On this episode, we're going to get our life changed with Lil Baby.
Fuck.
We're going to hate on one of the most likable players in the NBA. And on the late night deep cut, we're going commando.
I mean, it is kind of hot out.
You're going to want to stick around for that to get a full explanation on that, going commando on the late night deep cut. But we lead off these episodes with the weekly highlight. And like I said, this week, it's a little baby.
Little baby.
This is the latest.
No crybaby.
Not a crybaby. He's a full-grown man at this point. But Lil Baby in his latest life changed. Robbie D, let's roll it.
He got to change life now, fellas. Cut that shit up, Quay. Don't know how to feel. I got some
feelings that I can't explain. Stay home. CDC 2020.
Bro, you got to go, bro.
We got the go going.
The go. You got to go,
got
shit.
The, go. Go. The continuity go. Of the word. Wrong, but you couldn't tell me I ain't know nothing. All I ever want was to put on and get my folks something. Knocking at my sister window, coming in at four something.
Got a nice little underground party.
Yeah, yeah. You know what else he's got? He's got that Novocaine flow going.
Yeah, he definitely talking the same way I am.
It sounds like he just got out of the dentist like our boy Filthy Smalls.
Look, there's the dentist right there. You didn't see him?
But look at his lips are not matching the lyrics, bro.
We got the knockoff version? Is this the official version or no?
Nah, this is the original. Hey, you know, sometimes when you edit, you don't worry about what's really going on.
Alright. Whoever edited this video just wanted to get as many goat shots in because that's a good looking goat right there. Goats are a good animal. That is a very solid animal right there.
I'm not really that big of a fan of Lil Baby, bro.
He's like number one in the world right now.
But he be rapping like I'm talking right now.
Yeah, I mean, plus he is telling everybody to stay home.
COVID
2022.
Yeah. He's not feeling this open everything back up vibe going on.
They recorded this in 2022 and it just barely came out not too long ago.
Right. That would make more sense.
Yeah.
Is he trying to go for a farm vibe here? Because the print on the jacket in the goat shot. Just saying.
Metaphor.
Could be.
I don't even know what he's doing in the video, bro.
I think
he's robbing the store.
That he's trying to tell himself stay home so you don't go out and commit robbery.
It kind of looked like he was organizing the shelves.
Oh, so he's staying late.
Yeah. I mean, you gotta put in that work. That's why you're the
OT.
That's why you're the GOAT, because you put in that work.
Yeah, it makes sense. You know.
Yeah, pretty sure he was organizing the shelves, bro.
Yeah, I'm going to agree with you on that. I mean, how else is he going to work up the money to feed that goat?
But my thing is, how are you just going to be chilling with the goat?
His goats are awesome. Why wouldn't you be?
I don't know. Some lamb chops. Pork.
A lamb is a different animal.
You know, it's the same concept.
Yeah, farm animals, livestock.
But you can't eat them if you give them a name, bro.
Those are the rules.
But yeah, I mean, but why would you have a goat just to...
To pet him.
As a pet.
Like a dog?
Yeah.
But he has horns, though.
But it doesn't make sense.
But he's badass.
He's a farm animal.
As opposed to a sheep who is a badass.
Whoa.
I think I got lost here. You know, farm animal, food, that's what I was thinking.
Well, talking about that, hey, I'm drinking Mountain Dew, sponsor me.
Yeah.
You know, sponsor your boy.
Yeah.
Lisping on.
If Nick's Instagram turns into him on the farm holding up Mountain Dew cans, that's what it's going to be.
The goat.
We're going to know what's the farm goat.
The farm goat, I'm going to name Mountain Dew.
Yeah, he just moved a little more west, but if he then moves back out east into east or west Kansas, as we call it, and moves onto a farm and bumps a little baby every day, we're going to know what happened. We're going to know when it started.
Thank you, Mountain Dew.
Thank you, Mountain Dew.
Hell yeah.
And thank you to the little baby.
The baby getting it in?
We know he was eating after this video. Might not have been eating goat or lamb chops, but... As Robbie D said, he's ranking it in lately.
OT, overtime.
Overtime. Got to get paid.
Make that money.
Any other thoughts on our guy, Lil Baby, before we move on from the weekly highlight?
I got nothing.
Robbie was really thrown by that goat.
He doesn't like the goat.
Because I'm wearing a goat shirt, so you know that two different metaphors.
Yeah. Well, no, it's literally the same thing. It's the one.
But then you guys started calling it a pet and all that stuff. I'm just thinking, like, whoa.
But it could be food. The greatest of all time pet.
Yeah, goats are the greatest of all farm animals.
Well, when I'm frying him on my grill, I'll think of that.
It's pretty mean, but if that's the way you want to play it.
I am hungry, though.
My bad. We just got like 1,000 dislikes just for that comment. Well, this guy's a monster.
The vegans out here are hitting unsubscribe as fast as they can. But
fuck.
We'll try to make it up to you folks out there. We'll think of something by the end of the episode. Anyways, you know what I'm hungry for?
What's that?
Some hate. So let's roll out another edition of The Haters Club.
Whoop!
And on this episode of The Haters Club, I'm a little conflicted because... If you're on Twitter like me, NBA Twitter, Nuggets Twitter, shout out at Nuggets Nation.
Denver, Colorado, baby.
So if you're up to speed on the Denver Nuggets, you know all about Bones Highland. And
getting it in.
His amazing rookie season last season and getting excited for a couple months from now when he's going to kick it into high gear for the second season. But hailing out of... Wilmington, Delaware, our guy Bones Highland dropped a rap album this offseason.
Yeah.
Which is known to happen. No shout out to Miles Bridges. He's in jail right now. No shout out to Miles Bridges. If you know, you know. But Bones Highland, he has his album going. And I decided when it started popping up in my timeline, I checked it out. I scoped it a little bit. And he had a video that he was posting and promoting and stuff, and that's all cool. We still all love you, Bones. I don't mean to do this to you, but the video wasn't that good, and the song really isn't that good. So I just decided, like, let's roll this out in the Haters Club and see what happens.
I have not heard this song yet, but just from reviews.
the review.
It doesn't sound pretty good.
Bro, that picture looks like the apartment I had on the east side, bro.
It could be. It could be. We're about to find out. And it just as a quick disclaimer, the name Bones Highland, does that ring a bell for either of you?
No.
No.
You guys got to get on Twitter more.
I told you I hate Twitter.
At Busy Bones. Shout out to Busy Bones. But for the Haters Club, let's get to it.
What is that?
Dougie, Nesco, and Busy. What else need be said?
I don't know what to say about this. That's what I gotta say. Whoa, calm down, homie.
Yeah, let's go. Let's wrap it up here, fellas.
Hey, he's talking about bitches, but there are no bitches, though.
Yeah, I don't see no females there.
You just say you're fucking with the bum? I thought he made more money to be in a better place than that.
Well, he is on his rookie contract, so. He's not on that Nikola Jokic money yet.
Yeah. Well.
Yeah, time will tell.
I don't know. I think he's just going to have to stay the ball in.
I think you should give up, bro.
Yeah.
I'll quit the day job.
That food does look like a crackhead, though.
Yeah, and the mix on this is terrible.
Why would you just scream in the middle of your video?
I like the commitment to the three shot max. How they only had three scenes. It's like, nope, we're not taking this camera anywhere else.
You guys notice the dude in the corner? He's just texting the entire time.
He's like, I'm not fucking. I don't want to be seen on this shit.
Like, I'll be here because you said.
Yeah, if you look to the right of the screen, he's texting the entire time.
Dude, these motherfuckers have way too much fucking fun with this nonsense.
Bro, they're all like fucked up or something. Goodbye.
Man, I don't know if that's...
That was probably looking at some porno on this one.
Hey, you gotta find some way to pass your time with this going on.
It kind of hurts the Denver music scene right now.
Yeah, this is... I mean, CFR, we've been trying to hold it down, but this is not helping.
What's happening, bro?
Part 2, Scam Rap. And you can tell that they just pulled random beats because this beat is like way quieter in the mix.
Yeah.
That's still no good, bro.
It's the same house, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, it said answer my question. Duh.
But you can tell he's a rookie, huh? He's all skinny still.
All scrawny. Yeah. Like the one light. Purple, 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 blue. Purple, purple, purple.
This was funny.
I got no words.
Me neither, bro. I'm like, kind of like,
I'm just like, I'm watching it, and I'm just, I don't know. I'm just, yeah, I don't know.
It's tough. It's tough. You know, there's only so much you can say aside from that was terrible. And
facts.
Let's not do that again.
Facts.
Let's focus on the basketball.
Please.
That's the breadwinner right there.
Aside from 76ers fans right now, we're Bones Highland's biggest haters.
Yeah, your shit's garbage, homie.
Sorry to say. Like I said, Bones, we love you, but come on.
I got nothing, bro.
So
speechless.
Quick notes on Bones Highland. 21 years old, like I said, out of Wilmington, Delaware. And when just to keep us honest here, when you guys were 21 years old, were you putting out a higher quality product? Or if you listened back to yourself at 21 years old, would you put it on the haters club?
Facts.
I probably wouldn't, because I was sitting in prison at 21.
You weren't copping any beats there?
Just fucking catching some hands. That's about it.
Okay. Fair enough. But Filthy, the 21-year-old Filthy Smalls.
Bro, I'll put our new shit on the haters club, bro.
No, that's the truth. Every time we play one of our songs, Filthy's is like, nah, I hate this.
You got to play it 2 years into the future. So 2 years from now, Filthy's going to love this. The song that we just put out.
Yeah.
It could be the case. Are you going to love Thuggy by Busy and TG Nesco?
I'm going to have to give it a good thumbs down there, Ebert.
I'm going to probably go hurt myself a little bit later because of this song, bro.
Yeah, you can hear the 21-year-old in that song.
Whoa.
I mean, there was no bitches there. First of all, dude was sitting there texting the whole time, so he wasn't into it.
There was some bitches on that fool's phone.
Yeah. That he was trying to hook it up for after. He's like, okay, well, after I bounce from here.
No, I can't get no chicks today, fellas. I'm sorry. I failed all you guys.
Sorry,
like,
guys.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to try to get some bitches over here because this looks like a whack-ass video.
this is just... The thing is this shows too much time. Bones has too much time on his hands.
Are you practicing them free throws, homie?
I think next summer Nikola Jokic is going to have to take him back to Serbia with him and lock him in one of the. He has these horse stables that he trains in, runs his horses. He's going to have to keep Bones occupied with that next summer.
I don't think we want to do that because, you know, have you seen today's news about basketball and Russia right now?
Oh, right. Shout out to Brittany Griner. Free BG.
But I'm just saying, like, it's been in the news a lot lately. So I'm just saying, I don't think we want to take another NBA player back to that side of the world.
Yeah. The fingers crossed that Bones does not have his NBA career take a different trajectory and then he ends up overseas and then gets arrested. That would not be what we want. We want him here in Denver.
Stay home in Denver, homie.
We want him on the floor with the Nuggets uniform, holding it down that end.
No more videos.
No more videos, Bones.
No more rapping.
That's it. We're going to wrap this up, full stop. And Bones, if you're out there in Denver, that's the other thing. You think they shot that in Denver, or was he kicking in Wilmington, Delaware?
It kind of does. I don't know if you've recognized Denver architecture lately, but... Yeah, it's changing, and that's kind of the style.
So we'll at least leave on a positive note. At least he filmed it here. If he filmed it in Delaware and we find that out later, that's the last bit of hate. Come on.
Yeah, that'd be kind of fucked up.
Film it here in Denver, man. We film in Denver. Come on. Every day.
Every time.
Yeah, except for when we take this show on the road to Club Onyx in Houston, Texas.
Futuristic.
Crazy Days, North Carolina.
Shout out to Viper.
It's going to happen. The word strip club roadshow, which must mean it's time for the late night deep cut.
Hell yeah.
So, on the late night deep cut, we had several contenders. Shout out to the Denver Nuggets, too. Contenders, 2023 championship on deck. But we had several contenders for the late night deep cut today.
Yeah, it was definitely a rough pick for this one.
It was a tough call, but we landed on the big homie, Big Sizzle.
Sizzle.
Wearing no drawers.
Commando.
Yeah. That's what the Robbie D was saying at the beginning of the show. I mean, it's been hot as hell here in Denver the past couple of weeks.
Yeah.
So if you're going around with no drawers, we've got you on lock. Let's roll it.
I mean, when your AC breaks out, you're going to be bumping this song.
Bro, it's way too hot to be driving in a convertible, man.
Because you're going to be wearing no drawers.
You got some Clippers jersey?
Yeah, shout out to 2001.
Yeah, dude. He's repping the Lakers and the Clippers for some reason. But he's got the nice Lamar Odom jersey. And he has the replica Shaq jersey. I mean, how do you go cheap on the Lakers one? How does that work? Just saying.
I mean, you spend all your money on one, you got to save up for the other.
That would make sense. And I like the... we're going to have to line up the timeline. That one instrument sounds like the... Was that an Aaliyah song? That beat? Did Timbaland steal it from Big Sizzle?
I mean, it was 2001. They were sampling everything.
Yeah, we're going to have to line up these timelines to see who stole from who.
What is he even saying in the background?
We're going to roll it back after we record and listen carefully to it.
These girls don't even look happy either.
Part about being in a music video, bro.
Happy looks happy.
Yeah, the guys are happy.
Hey, look at his long ass chain. Everybody has the chokers right now.
Yeah. Throwback style.
Takes off the panties. Damn.
They're all fighting the bouncer?
Yeah, they want to get in there with the chicks with no drawers on.
It's going to get sweaty in there, though.
100 degrees outside. Everybody ain't got no drawers on.
Nope. She's sweating.
Yeah. Why do you think? If she's wearing no drawers, why would she?
Told you they sampled everything. That was fucking Method Man right there. Gravel Pit.
I got you.
Stealing everything. We're going to steal it. We're going to start stealing songs too. Again.
What do you think of the fire background? I mean, it's literally fire.
Real fire?
That's why I ain't got no drawers on. It's fucking hot.
Hell yeah. I'd be like, bro, it's already hot as fuck outside and you have pyrotechnics in?
Yeah.
No Draws is the name of the album. Nope, not happening, lady.
You didn't want them.
Get lost. You don't have to wrap up the party, but you ain't partying here.
Facts.
Nah, those ones probably stunk.
Too sweaty, bro.
You know what he told her. You clearly have drawers on. You cannot get in.
You didn't see his face. He grabbed the panties. He's like, damn. God damn. What the fuck? No, you got to go.
Yeah. 105 degrees at night.
Fuck that.
That's stanky.
Yeah. That's putting our guys in a precarious situation.
I don't want to.
And you know, I always say the continuity of the word. This is our first official callback to... I ain't got no panties on.
Put them panties off. Put them panties off on the dance floor.
Hey.
Put them panties off. Put them panties off on the dance floor.
Hey,
whoa. Oh, fuck.
You're going to want to go back to that classic episode of The Word and that monumental edition.
I ain't got no panties on.
Of
no
the panties. Late night deep cut. On the dance floor.
Oh, fuck.
Let's just do back-to-back late-night deep cuts, and let's have Robbie D put our late-night deep cut of No Panties on the Dance Floor up on the screen right now, just so we can relive that monumentous occasion.
We'll have to see what the editing works out to.
Yeah, we're going to have to up the ante with the editing here. But anyways.
But go check that shit out, though.
Yeah, seriously. We got our whole history of the word. If you go to our channel right now, like I said, lots of options. This is episode 23. If this isn't your vibe, like if you're Bone Silent sitting at home right now watching this and it's like, fuck these guys hating on me in my video.
Well, we live your basketball game, though.
But if you want to give us another shot, we got 22 other episodes you can check out.
Facts.
Yeah. And we got, what else we got? There was an episode where the power went out on us. That we didn't get that on film, obviously, but it was pretty funny.
Yeah, that was kind of, I wish we would have recorded that.
Yeah, well, we were this close to having the camera just shut off because the power went out. That would have been pretty legit. But anyways, lots of options. And any other thoughts on this edition of the pure fire of the late night deep cut?
That shit dope.
That's dope?
I don't know what I mean.
I like the stolen beat. We're on a stolen beat war path through this whole episode.
The lyrics on these songs weren't hitting my vibe.
Garbage.
I mean, I like the nostalgia from 2001. That was pretty good.
So, and the concepts. I like the concepts.
Yeah, I was trying to look it up. So like I said, continuity of the word. Bones Highland, NBA. So that guy with his Lamar Odom jersey. So Lamar Odom was on the Clippers from 99 to 2003 before he went to the Miami Heat. So that's a 4-year span that this video could have come from.
So you're saying this video is older than...
It's as old as Bones Highland, potentially.
Potentially just
if
as old.
If
this,
it was the year 2000.
This song came out the same time that he came out?
Pretty much. That's what we're figuring out.
That could be the case.
But
there's some nostalgia for you guys out there.
Okay, released 2001. Bones was born in 2000. So he was 1 year old when this song dropped and the pure fire went all over BET Uncut.
Wearing no drawers.
Stick to NBA.
So we're going to go cool off and start planning our next episode of The Word. As always, thank you for tuning in. We out.
Peace.
Put them panties off. Put them panties off on the dance floor.
Hey.
Put them panties off. Put them panties off on the dance floor.
Hey, listen.